Assalamualaikum. So kita sambung The Witcher 3. Quest seterusnya adalah Carnal Sin. Quest ni adalah untuk kita check apa yang terjadi pada Priscilla. Suppose ada perasmian untuk kedai baru dan dandelion. Tapi disebabkan ada kemalangan yang terjadi pada Priscilla, jadi saya rasa event tu tertunda. Jadi sekarang kita nak siasat siapakah dalang yang menyebabkan Priscilla cedera parah. Okay.
Oh. I've had enough of living.
Well then, ready for a stroll through the sewers?
Let's go.
Mm-hmm. Ready and intrigued.
You lead.
So, preventive medicine you practice in the sewers. What's that about?
Think. Sewing up the realm of victim. Hear that?
Been hearing it for a while. Draw your weapon. Straight, no sugarcoating.
Her wounds will heal, but it's her voice that concerns me. Surely you understand what a terrible blow that would be to a Trobriet, enough to strip her of the will to live.
Any remedy for that?
I fear only your friend Dandelion can be of help on that count.
Oh. Nampaknya Dandelion adalah watak yang agak utama untuk pulihkan Priscilla.
Take the ladder. This is the place. Come, the quicker we take care of this, the better.
Why? Got somewhere to be?
Someone might disturb us. The coroner, for example. Or Reverend Nathaniel Pastodi.
Very well.
We seek the corpse of a dwarven woodcarver.
Human, wrong body type. Let's keep looking.
Okay.
Looks like necrophage has got to this one.
Okay, bukan. So dia suruh cari dwarven.
Okay. Calluses on the fingers, sawdust in the beard, clothes sticky with sap. Must be our dwarf.
Excellent. I trust you don't grow weak in the knees at the sight of blood?
Not a bit. Start the autopsy.
Where?
Let's look at his head. Hair smells like it's burnt, like he was in a fire.
Notice anything else? That his eyes have been scooped out, for instance?
Those burn marks I see in his eye sockets.
Yes, and some gray dust. Ash, it seems. Very fine.
Murderer gouged out his eyes, then put burning coals in the sockets.
So it seems. Looking at the wounds, it appears our woodcarver was still alive when it happened.
Okay.
Let's examine the mouth. Burns, blisters.
Just like Priscilla's.
See this? Incision made into the voice box.
Indeed, so thin as to be nearly unnoticeable.
A small, extremely sharp instrument. Scalpel.
But why? The wound is too small to bleed, and there are signs of swelling. The murderer... I believe he performed a tracheotomy, so the victim wouldn't die too soon.
All right, to LA. Torso.
Let's examine his torso.
What have we here? Deep wound on the left side of his rib cage, and a scar the length of his stomach.
Let's examine the chest wound. Yeah, heart carved out, wound cauterized.
Wait a minute, there's something else.
An egg from an amphibian. A salamander? Scorched but intact.
I attended some lectures in herpetology as a student. Afraid I don't recall any amphibians that would lay eggs in corpses. So either Professor Cochrane was deeply mistaken, or this is our murderer's doing.
Open the abdominal cavity.
Due warning, it will stink of rot.
Once fought a zoogle up to my waist in sewage, so I doubt... Wait. Smells not rot.
Formaldehyde. A medical novelty. Heavily diluted, it's remarkable at preserving organic tissue. In stronger proportions, it's more destructive than acid.
Explains why there's no smell of decay, and why his throat scalded.
Okay, scar.
Look at the scar. Wounds long and thin, an incision, but the edges are ragged.
Means nothing. Look, no swelling, no bruises. An old injury, perhaps an accident in the workplace.
Right. Do you want hand?
Look at his hands. These welts. Rope burns, right? He was tied up.
I'd expect so. No one could sit through such torture unless bound.
Speaking from experience?
Yes, that of a victim. Spent a year in the dungeons of Tretagor. Long story.
Some other time, maybe. See the callus? Our dwarf wore a ring, but someone took it off him.
Lake.
See anything interesting on his legs?
His right foot. The ankle swollen, toenails broken. He clearly kicked something very hard, right before he kicked the bucket.
Doesn't strike me as the right time for jokes.
Apologies. We surgeons, we've a different sensibility.
Mm-hmm. And a different sense of humor.
Okay.
His genitals. We ought to inspect those.
I sincerely doubt they bear any relation to the matter.
We'll see. Pull down his trousers and... shit.
Syphilis, actually. Early stages. No sign of diffusion.
Think there could be a connection?
Only as the killer's potential motivation.
Okay.
All right. Think I know enough.
In Enlighten me, please, because I've still no notion what this is about, what the motive might have been.
Okay. So...
No motive to speak of. Murder is mad, plain and simple.
Unfortunate. Such individuals are hardest to catch.
It's a lead worth following. Any idea what his name was?
Fabian Meyer. And I'm Hubert Reich, the coroner. I've come to perform the autopsy, but I see you've done it for me, Joachim. As always, you interfere where you're neither needed nor wanted. Drag others into trouble in the process. Who is this?
A student. Lifelong learner. Got a couple questions for you.
Very well, speak. But be quick. Reverend Nathaniel has come by for an inspection. He'll be here shortly.
You old friends?
Hubert taught me the rudiments of medicine. Long ago.
And not very well. You've still not mastered certain basic principles. For example, that a doctor's role is to treat the ill, not save the world.
You've not changed a bit.
A compliment?
No, a statement of fact. 30 years, and you've not changed a bit.
Woodcarver's body. Where was it found? It's important.
Plan to investigate? Exciting. He died in his workshop south of the market square, just beside the gate to Far Corners. That poor Trebirits was attacked there. City's abuzz about it. But the woodcarver, Eustace the corpse collector, brought us the body. You should speak to him. Saw him just around the corner near... Oh, greetings, your reverence.
Who are these people? I believe I made it clear no one's to be allowed in under any circumstances.
You did, but they're friends of the deceased. Here to collect the body.
Out of the question. Show them out at once.
As your reverence wishes. Gentlemen, follow me. You shall leave via another route.
Why do you cover for us?
I was covering my own arse. If Reverend Nathaniel had learned someone had entered the morgue, then cut open a corpse without his permission, I'd be in deep trouble. But you didn't give that a thought, did you, Joachim? As ever. Well, while I don't approve of your willfulness, I also wish to see this murderer hang. So, should I learn anything new related to this case, I will let you know.
Thank you.
Alright.
Nathaniel, who is he?
A scoundrel, a rogue. Like every man who wears the robes of the Eternal Fire.
Most are scoundrels before they ever put on the robes.
True in his case as well. Before he donned the frock, Nathaniel was a torturer. Delighted especially in torturing women. Later, Hierarch Himmelfahrt appointed him to oversee the morgue. He deals with the temple guard, supervises cremations, conducts funeral masses in the temple on the isle, and so forth.
Dream job. Might have told me you know the coroner. We could have skipped the trip through the sewers.
I know him, thus I avoid him. I've said enough on the subject.
I decide when we're done with the subject. What's your connection to him?
An old story, but if you insist... The student protests in 1242, you've heard of them? I led them. Hubert, however, denounced me to the authorities. I landed in prison. There you have it. What will you do now?
Plenty of leads. Woodcarver's workshop, the corpse collector who found him, alley where Priscilla was attacked. Got work to do.
As do I. At the hospital. I must return there. But I shall keep my fingers crossed.
And I'll keep my eye on you.
Okay. So, rasanya kita punya cat macam dah habis. Okay. Dah habis lama tapi baru pulang. So, kita akan investigate. First, oh agak jauh. Jadi kita ambil terdekat dulu.
rain again. Damn mages.
Bloody bandits! Can't go out in the streets no more!
Mr. Bolivian, you must be mad running around in this rain!
You'll get no mercy, no
You, Eustace, the corpse collector?
I? How'd you know?
Fourth sense, I think it is. You bring Fabian Meyer's body to the morgue.
Oh, yeah, I remember. No ice, no art, one of them, right? No purse neither, as I recall.
One of them? So there have been other bodies like that?
Sure have. Beggars, street urchins, and street walkers. One went so portly, I had to cut her into pieces to fit her in me wheelbarrow. Slippery Sal, they called her, on account of her.
Some things are best left unsaid. What happened to the pieces?
What do you mean? Reverend Nathaniel ordered them burned. Every last one. Oh, shame that was.
Shame? Why? Actually, never mind. Another thing that's best left unsaid.
Jay?
You search Fabian's body?
Well, I cast an eye in his pockets. Made sure nothing went to waste.
I call a spade a spade. You rob corpses.
And I call a prick. It's none of your fucking concern. What, you tax collector? Piss off, mutant.
Oh, middle finger, boy.
Talk. What did you find on him?
I had you wish. Triflings, baubles, gloss beaded wing, handful of coins, and a letter. Look, vellum, quality parchment, that. I'll wipe off the writing and sell it as new.
That's human skin. Priscilla, next victim's name. If you'd given this to the right person, she might not have been hurt.
What the fuck do I care what happens to some Priscilla? We short of wenches in this town.
Okay. Hit him.
Boy, fucking hell! What was that for?
For everything.
I see that. So, kemudian... Tengok tempat Priscilla kena
tag. What happened here?
Kita di sebelah je dengan ni. Ini sedikit.
No, I'm sure to get a signal.
No. So katanya dekat sini. Priscilla dulu, kemudian baru kita
look awfully suspicious to me, tramp.
Kita pergi satu lagi. Silap.
Oh.
First.
axes. Get him.
How am I to know? Watch him, see what he does.
Priscilla's.
Fucking come on!
Is he? Okay.
Hey, what?
Pathetic. Gonna hurt you. What are you doing here?
Getting vengeance. Well, why are you staring? Have you not heard killers always return to the scene of their crime? Me and my brothers are waiting here to give him a warm welcome for Priscilla. Almost did her in the whole sun.
I know. Here to look for clues and find anyone who might know something.
Fear I can't help you much, but I can tell you what I know.
Priscilla wasn't the sole victim. You aware of that?
Oh, dearie. Of course I was. This didn't start yesterday. Others have died like this before. Beggars, street girls, orphans. But who'd have a drama concern about them? Human rubbish. It's what the guards call us.
Recall any names?
They didn't have proper ones. Baldy, curly, buns. That's what folk called them. No friends, no families. Their bodies were burned long ago.
You and Priscilla friends?
Friends? Nah. But she saw more than a stupid whore in me. Treated me with respect. It mattered. I was looking to give up whoring, pick up a decent trade. But none would take me. Not as a washerwoman, nor a servant, nor a cook. Felt like a leper, I did. But Priscilla, she was different. Agreed to put me in her play, you see? Lots of the other actors, they were afraid on account of her jesting about the eternal fire. Whistling Wendy on stage, can you imagine it? Well, dream's gone now. I'm back to working street corners.
Sorry to hear that.
You could do worse as work goes. Also, I tell myself.
Take care now. I gotta look around some more. Appreciate it if you didn't disturb me.
Naturally. We'll stand aside, behave. Do tell us if you find anything else here.
Oh, my head's ringing. Watch it, Tram. Nobody grabs not your stomping ground.
A brazier. This time of year? I know that smell. Formaldehyde.
Mana lagi? Alright.
Man's footprint. The murderers maybe. Wait on his heel. Took a step back.
Okay. So last one.
Oi, Witcher! Coroner wants to see you. Been another victim. Told me to say the main door will be open for you. You're to come as soon as you can.
Good.
Anyone home?
Be gone, or I'll set me hounds on you. Molly, Strieger, come!
Relax. I'm here about Fabian Meyer, looking for his killer.
That's altogether different. Sit, you stupid mutts, lie down!
Come on. Come on in. Slowly now, lest they bite you.
Charming as beasts go.
You daft? Even I'm scared of them. A better barking dog than an evil man at your door.
Got someone particular in mind?
Sure as shite. Bugger who did Fabian in. As soon as they'd hauled his corpse off, I run to a mate who raises fighting dogs. But these two mutts cost me a chunk of change. And I sleep sound, at least.
Okay.
So who might you be?
The Stiff's brother. Gus is the name. We ran a workshop together. Meyer and Meyer.
What'll it be now? Just Meyer?
Name it. I'll be closing it down now. As soon as I find a buyer for this shack, I'll head on to Mahakam. Be near my family or what's left of it. So, what do you want to know? What can I tell you about Fabian?
Your brother have any enemies? Anyone dislike him? Threaten him, maybe?
T'was Fabian who threatened this one lass. Well, you were a good dwarf, a craftsman like no other. But he were an incorrigible whoremonger as well. Whenever we put a bit of coin aside, I'd say, let's buy some tools, quality timber. No, he grabbed the purse and head out whoring. Took to following one in particular. He'd say, "'Tis all your fault, dirty bitch, human dishrag." And other obscenities. Don't rightly know what that was about. Maybe he was in love with her.
Know where I can find her, this dishrag?
City cemetery. She died a few days back, quietly in her sleep. Her paunt said a fever took her.
Tell me what you know about the murder, in order, in detail.
T'was like this. Had some work in Oxenfurt, and I was coming home. Saw a plume of smoke rising over the city. Thought to myself, blast it, gonna miss and burn another hag. But the smoke wasn't coming from Hyrax Square. It was coming from here. See the soot stains? That's where they burned our sculptures. Folk gathered around the blaze, and found Fabian here beside it. They'd already loaded him on the cart by the time I arrived.
Talk to your neighbors. They see anything suspicious beforehand? Hear anything?
Claimed not to. But even if they had, they'd not have helped. In Novigrad, folk give bleeding orphans in the street a wide berth so as not to stain their poor lanes. They'd care about some dwarf.
All right, talk enough.
Fine, we've talked enough. Need to look around.
Be my guest. Just beware of the dogs.
Bloodstains.
That's where Fabian lay when they found him.
Statues of the old gods. Nothing but women. Shapely ones.
Murderer dragged something heavy.
Dragged something across the floor.
Statues.
Or dragged it from one wall to the other. Repeatedly.
Semua daripada macam surat ni dah. Wisconsin citizen. Alright.
Mind if I go inside the workshop?
I've not even peeked inside since they found Fabian. But I'll open it for you if you want.
Say he bled to death. Unless...
formaldehyde. Doubt Fabian used it.
Okay. Ting.
Eyes. Humanoid. Completely rotten. Furniture got knocked over. This looks like it was kicked.
Aye.
Had a look at your sculptures.
What? lifelike, aren't they?
Mm-hmm. The women especially. Never seen a bust that size on Melitale.
Oh, aye. Fabian's handiwork. I told him, brother, tits like that would crush her back. Whittle him down. He said, nay, they'd sell better this way. Told me to shut me trap. And sell they did. Till one sermon at the temple, and the celebrating reverend said that whoso buys idols from the non-human mires sins twofold, as a heretic and as a lecher. That was the end of that.
Already know what happened. Fabian was in the workshop. Murderer attacked him there. They struggled. Fabian was overpowered, then tortured for a time.
I needn't know the details. Truth be told, I haven't the stomach for him.
When it was over, the murderer dragged Fabian to the courtyard, then made a pyre of sculptures, set them aflame.
But why? Why do all that?
To teach a lesson. To him, you, the whole city. Fine, we've talked enough. Won't learn anything else here. Take care.
All right. Corona, Corona, Corona. So kita akan pergi kepada Corona dan dapatkan info dekat kes terbaru, kes pembunuhan. Lagi ya. See, banyak kertas tu. So rasa something fishy sedang berlaku.
It's everywhere. I see it all around.
Move on. All
right.
Welcome, Master Witcher.
Oh, you call me Master just now.
Geralt, right? I'm glad you're here. Held off on the autopsy till you arrived.
Nice of you, especially given you didn't seem pleased about my previous visit.
Because you came unannounced and in unfortunate company. I also had Reverend Nathaniel to contend with. Our spiritual caretaker has left the city on some important matter, and I know who you are, what drives you. I'm more than happy to aid your investigation.
All right.
Not fond of Nathaniel?
Very few people are. He's cruel and capricious. He stormed in here once, grabbed a scalpel I was sterilizing over a burner, sliced my back with it to the bone. Because I had forgotten to lock the storeroom. Hard to be fond of someone like that, wouldn't you agree?
Okay.
Who's the victim this time?
Joris Aquinas, a lecturer in theology at Oxenfurt Academy. Found this morning at his home on a catafalque made of his books.
Any titles in particular?
It seems all the tomes dealt with the eternal fire. Treatises critical of the faith's doctrines.
Yeah. Mortal sin in Novigrad. Von Gratz told me all about you.
Ah. Doubtless you've heard how I had the noble leader of the student protesters thrown in prison. But did you hear the protests were far from peaceful? Or did he neglect to mention it? People were dying, Witcher. Those who rejected liberty, equality, and fraternity would be found in the gutter come morning. Their throats slit from ear to ear with surgical precision. Joachim had been my favorite student, but alas, I had to do something. So I reported him. Then I left the university and found work in the morgue, where none care about my past. Whereas Joachim, oh, fate's ironies. Years later, he was appointed head of the very ward I had founded.
How old's Von Gratz? 50? 60?
53, I believe. Why do you ask?
You look a little young to have been his teacher.
Not surprising. For years, I've lived in the cold and dark, breathing the vapors of embalming fluids. In short, working with corpses extends one's life. Amusing, is it not?
Right.
Let's start.
Gladly. The wounds conform to the killer's modus operandi. The victim was bound and forced to drink formaldehyde. Next, the killer removed the eyes, placed burning coals in the sockets, then opened the rib cage and... What's this? A parchment. Made of human skin.
A message from the murderer. The name of his next victim. Patricia Vagelbud.
Do you know her?
Yes. Even went to her estate once with... Gotta find her, now.
Let's go, so we might find the murder. Patricia. Where are you?
Till next time, master.
Alright. So, pembunuh ni meninggalkan nama untuk kita jejak dia. Mana dia berada? Okey. Siapa nak lari sejauh tu? Oh, gelap. Sorry. Okey. Let's get him.
Need to talk to Patricia Vagelbud.
You think any bum off the street can...
Her life's in danger. Let me in or have her blood on your hands.
If you thought this up, and I let you in, I'll throw my arse out the door.
Always thought a guard was supposed to protect his charge, not his ass.
So be it. I'll take you to Lady Vagelbud. Just no trickery. Understand?
Geralt, what a pleasant surprise.
Not pleasant at all. I gotta see your mother. Her life's in danger.
In danger? Come now. I saw mother this morning. She seemed sad, true, but in perfect health.
I'm hunting a serial killer, and I've got reason to believe your mother will be his next victim.
Why, even if it's true, our guards.
He's exceptionally cruel when he kills. Tortures his victims, cuts out their hearts. So let's see how she is, just in case.
I find this all very hard to believe, but you appear to be quite serious. Please, follow me.
A fire fit for Bellatane, except it's the wrong time of year.
I mentioned Mother seemed sad. Do you remember? In fact, she's in the midst of a crisis of faith. A rather serious one. We've been to Novigrad. Mother had seen the prayers in Hierarch Square. Uttered not a word on our way home. She had all the holy books, insignias, reliquaries gathered, taken outside and burnt. Then she locked herself in her room.
We need to hurry.
Hear that? Calm and quiet. All seems to be in order.
We should go in, just to be sure.
You're relentless, aren't you? Fine. But wait here, please. Mother's certainly not in the mood for guests.
Okay.
Oh! He ran out the other door! Catch him!
Hey.
We're still here!
I'll break your bones!
I've no time for this.
There he is! Get him!
Oh, you
tiba-tiba. Terlepas.
Halt! Or I'll put a bolt between your eyes!
Listen, you got the wrong guy.
Save your trickery! Taking you to the heiress!
Well, killer's already escaped. Lead the way, hero.
Tak dapat bicara.
We got him, Lady Ingrid. Wasn't easy, but...
Lower that crossbow before you hurt yourself. This man is innocent.
Forgive me. I saw him running. Thought it was the killer fleeing.
I was chasing him, and I'd have caught him if you hadn't gotten in my way.
Out of my sight, at once! Mother! Why did he do this to her? Why?
I don't know. Too early to draw any conclusions. Ingrid, I know this is a hard time for you, but usually the killer leaves a note on the body. A note indicating his next victim. May I?
Very well. But you should be on your own. I do not wish to see her in this state. I do not wish to remember her like that. And let her be the last victim. Please.
Alright, so this time kita fail nak tangkap. Sebabkan anjing dengan guard tu.
Bruises, broken fingernails. She defended herself. Must be why it took him longer, and why he almost got caught. Here it is. Sweet Nettie, crippled Cates. Growing bolder, not just the name, but the place too. Won't get away this time.
Uh-oh. Okay.
Same wounds as the previous victims. Examination would be a waste of time. Gotta get to crippled Cates, fast.
So, kalau ada time tu kita loot, kita akan loot. By far, kita dah bunuh semua anjing dia. Wow! Bahaya. Saja kita nak habiskan dried fruit and nut. This time yang paling dekat adalah square.
Do not disturb them.
Bloody hell.
Like what you see? You've got brawny thighs, stranger.
buff lagi.
No one will hear you, bitch. Not a soul.
You though, whole town will hear you in a minute.
Yet again you disturb me. And I so dislike being disturbed. I was to play with sweet Nettie, render her not so sweet, but I shall see to you first.
First, gotta tell me why you do it.
For pleasure. Satisfaction.
Achievable with whores in a lot of ways, many traditional. Doesn't take killing them, trust me.
Who said anything about killing? I could stop a few burns. Third degree, but still. This rosy skin will roast quite well.
Just can't listen to any more of this shit.
No one's forcing you to, mutant.
Done. Oops, Nettie, sorry, tak nak tengok.
You're free now.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. If not for you.
Okay, this one.
He asked if I did everything I said for the right price, of course. Then he smiled. Oh God, it gave me the shivers. And then he hit me so hard I passed out. I was bound when I came to. And he was hitting the poker in the fire.
Calm down. He won't hurt you anymore. He won't hurt anyone.
Okay. So that's it. Kita loot.
No credit.
Ugh. What grace, what style.
Okay, let me go to the... So, kita balas stand-up. Sekarang... Kita akan travel. So game Witcher ni satu je lah yang membuatkan kita agak menyampah tu. Nak kena travel jauh.
Better, right?
Yes.
Did you take care of what I asked?
Yeah. The Witcher's way.
Thank you, Geralt. For me and Priscilla.
Did my part. Your turn now. Take care of her. Good care.
I will. You'll see. Treat her better than the Dryads of Brokkamon could.
She's talking again. Nice surprise.
Isn't it? Professor Von Gratz told me her wounds are healing faster than a troll's. Not the most flattering comparison, but encouraging. Maybe she might even sing again someday. For now, we'll try performing as a duo. She'll play the lute, I'll sing. Dandelion and Calinetta. Got a nice ring to it, doesn't it?
Sounds great. Good luck, Dandelion. On stage and off.
Okay, so kita dah habis quest Carnot scene dan kita dah menuntut bela kejadian yang jadi pada semua orang. So sampai situ, next quest akan datang. Thank you.